I'm just glad you didn't like ask me about a cod piece or like that.
Why don't couples want a diamond?
It might be that somebody really wants to do something different. They want to create their own traditions. It's very important to this generation. And they might view having a diamond as being socially irresponsible. Now that's something that we'll tackle probably
in future
episodes. I think there was a lot of misinformation maybe more a decade ago than there is now about the practicality of other gemstones in the ring. And I think a lot of that has been corrected. When you're talking about these gemstones, whether we're talking about the ones that you want to avoid or the ones that you want to gravitate to, the first thing you want to do is you want to look at the hardness of the gemstone. A diamond is the hardest material on earth, right? A diamond is a 10 on Mohs hardness scale.
Top three gemstones to avoid if you don't want a diamond. Number three, quartz.
The gemstone variety of quartz, there's a couple, but there would be amethyst is the most well-known. When somebody comes in, they say, well, I really don't want a diamond. Mm-hmm. I want a amethyst.
Right.
The proper follow-up question for any professional jeweler would be, okay, this is your engagement ring. Is this something you want to wear every day? Because the reality is, if you're going to wear it every day, something in the hardness level of quartz, which I believe is like 7 to 7.5, somewhere in that range, that's really not hard enough to wear every day. Okay. You're going to scratch it. And people will say, well, I'm not that hard on my jewelry. Living your life is hard on your jewelry. Trust me. If you have an office job and you put your hand into a filing cabinet and you grab the end of the filing cabinet, done. That stone is scratched. I'm obviously square in the middle of Generation X, but I always say that I have way more in common with millennials than I do with my own generation. So
that's exactly
probably why we're such good friends.
That's what a Gen Xer would say.
Is it? That's so Gen X of me.
I have so much in common with those Utes. Number two.
Yes.
This one actually made me sad because I love the way this gemstone looks. Oh. But number two, emerald.
Emerald actually has relatively decent hardness. So it's a 7.5 to 8, but it's deceptive. Because another thing that you need to consider is toughness of the gem.
Toughness.
So hardness is the gem's resistance to scratches.
Yes.
The toughness is the gemstone's resistance to chipping. And emeralds do not possess very high toughness.
It's risky.
It's risky.
Toughness is risky.
The toughness is
Yeah. Do you find people are like let down by that?
Yeah, because it might be something that she's always dreamed of having in her engagement ring. And that is a tough conversation for us to have.
Number one though, the top gemstone to avoid in your engagement ring if you don't want a diamond, opal.
Yeah, it's very soft. I don't even know off the top of my head what the hardness of opal would be.
But it's measured more in softness.
Yeah, softness, it's quite soft. Right. So this is why, by the way, that I feel like regardless of where somebody decides to shop, gemological accreditation is important. It's important for that store to know the difference of these things. There's no way somebody should walk through the store and understand that the hardness of an emerald is a 7.5 to 8. I would prefer for your questions to be harder because I like to learn things.
I thought you knew all things jewelry.
No.
Clearly,
no.
I overestimated.
No, I very specifically said last time that I don't.
they're
going to act like they knew, but
they didn't.
I can think of at least 5 people that didn't know it. You know who you are.